I just wanted to talk about today, something really, really important for all of humanity. Everybody's got a lot of different opinions in this world. The world's something full of all kinds of different ideas. But the thing I wanted to talk about is thought about some people that don't believe in Christianity for a lot of different reasons. And, I want to make sure that we can at least establish some kind of a focal point, because if we're talking about two different things, it doesn't really help much to try and discuss who's right, who's wrong, you know? If it's all about books and pages and who studied this and what have you learned and who told you, it doesn't really matter. But the final question for Christianity is whether or not we've been touched by God or not. The real gospel was never meant to be just one of those pages. And as far as we can realize, that the Bible teaches us that the church was never meant to be just people who believe in a book, but people who knew God, people who've been touched from on high, people who've been touched from God. They've been touched from heaven. And there's a very big difference between people who believe in a Bible and those who have been touched by God, those who have truly been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. It's a real transformation that only God can do. And the truth is, either God has done that for us, or yet we are still a natural man. Amen? So it ends up not becoming, it's not a matter of morality, whether or not you're good or you're bad. It's a matter of one thing, whether or not you're born again of the Spirit of God or not. The Spirit of God is what comes to teach you eternal life. But God has given everybody a little bit of life, eternity on our hearts, to recognize that there's more to this natural life. This natural life will last us about 75 years. And then
what?
I want to make sure people can have a chance to know that eternal life is something that happens to you. It's not something you just believe in. Believing in the gospel is a gospel of power. The gospel happens to people who really want to be born again, and those who want to come to please the Lord. And the Lord will lead you from your sin into what He wants for you. The Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord has come to heal the brokenhearted. Amen? Come to heal the brokenhearted and set them apart for His will. And after the Lord begins to heal you, He wants to start to sanctify you and start to change you from the inside out. For those that are born again, they know that God does a mighty work in people's lives. He changes people to be sons and daughters of God. It's not about morality, because morality, nobody is good enough to go to heaven. Nobody is good enough to go into heaven's gate. The Bible says that without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. And so we have not come to Jesus to have our sins washed away, but our sins still remain. And it's not going to be a walk to our sin. It's going to really come to Him and tell Him, Lord, I really want to do Your will. And one day He will wash you. He will set you apart. He will cleanse you. And if that hasn't happened to you, then the Bible says you're still a natural man. You're still a natural man. And the things of the Spirit are foolishness to the natural man. The things of the Spirit do not make sense to those who have not experienced the supernatural. If the works of eternity have not happened in your heart, then the gospel is foolishness to them that will not see Him. They don't see Him. So it's okay if people want to mock. It's okay if people scoff at you and say, hey, you're crazy. You don't know what you're talking about. I say, I do know what I'm talking about. Not because of what I've been taught, but because of who I've met. Only those who've been touched by God will understand. Because that's the rock of all I'm talking about. That's the rock of the gospel that the Lord does teach. Amen? The Lord teaches the gospel of the power of God. Jesus says to Simon Bar-Jonah, He says, who do you say that I am? And Simon Bar-Jonah says, you are Christ. You are the Son of the living God. And Jesus marvels at the answer because He knows He's God to figure it out. The real gospel was not a gospel that was here to just believe it. The Father reveals His Son to you and lets you know that you're born again. When the Lord reveals His Son to you, when the Father reveals His Son to you and lets you know that this is indeed the Christ, this is My Son, in whom I'm well pleased. Until that has happened to you, Christianity is only in your mind. And the real gospel is not a mental religion, it is a supernatural religion.
I admit it is. The Bible says that the preaching of the cross is foolishness to them that perish. The Bible is full of learning to them that don't want to stop sinning. That's right. Have you met God? Yeah. There's a place where you can stop living in sin. No, because the world is its only God. Because if God made this people, God made this world to be pure. And this world has said no. And that's very annoying to God. If he made our sin, so he makes the rules. Anybody can have a direct connection to God. If you draw near to God, he'll draw near to you. I don't. Do you? Have you ever met God?
No, I don't.
I would like everybody to turn off their compromised sin. And you promise to stop sinning, I'll stop preaching. Okay? I serve the Lord, and the Lord God tells us to tell the world that this is forever. We don't have all this. We have a time limit. We will not be alive for 1,000 years. Most people don't even like to make it to 100 years. The average lifespan is about 75 years. After that, we still get to find out, oh, is telling the truth or not. Eternal life is for everybody. And it will be for everybody. We are eternal spirits looking outside of our physical body. That's where we are. Our bodies won't last forever, but our spirits will. Our souls are eternal. God made us to be right with him forever. And for those who reject him, for those who reject him,
right now, and we have a sin, 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 and we have a
healed of you. And that has your word in the physical gospel. Father, reveal his son to you and makes his very first reveal. More real than everything else that you've ever seen in the natural. Perhaps it becomes more important than that, but we realize that God is forever. Things that we can see are temporal, and the things that we can't see are those eternal things. The world is always judged because of sin. God said, I'm not going to say, heaven and earth will pass, but my word will never pass. So we're looking at what is wise eternally, not just on this earth. But those who want to be wise eternally, because of the snow in their car in their lives, that which can't fail. And the word of God can't fail. The grass withers, the flower fades, and the word of God will stand forever. And I want people to be lasting forever. I'm talking here not about, hey, you're judging me and my judgment.
The Holy Spirit is here to reveal the true and living
want to find him. Amen. The real Christ is a revealed Christ, supernaturally, who is to be born again of the Spirit. Amen. Okay, I'm going to for those that will be born again, there's a sense that your decision and God at the same time.
I just wanted to talk about today something really, really important for all of humanity. Everybody's got a lot of different opinions in this world. The world's often full of all kinds of different ideas. But the thing I wanted to talk about is thought about some people that don't believe in Christianity for a lot of different reasons. I want to make sure that we can at least establish some kind of a focal point, because if we're talking about two different things, it doesn't really help much to try to discuss who's right, who's wrong, you know? If it's all about books and pages and who studied this and what have you learned and who told you, it doesn't really matter. But the final question for Christianity is whether or not we've been touched by God or not. The real gospel was never meant to be just one of those pages. The church was never meant to be just people who believe in a book, but people who knew God, people who've been touched from on high, people who've been touched from God, they've been touched from heaven. And there's a very big difference between people who believe in a Bible and those who have been touched by God, those who have truly been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. It's a real transformation that only God can do. And the truth is, either God has done that for us, or yet we are still a natural man. Amen? So it ends up not becoming, it's not a matter of morality, whether or not you're good or you're bad. It's a matter of one thing, whether or not you're born again of the Spirit of God.